Okay, it's going on 6 o'clock, and he's asked for dinner at 7:30. The tomatoes are ready. These mushed down a little bit more. They were super ripe, but I've tasted them and they're just fine. I did rinse out with some of that boiling water from before when I got the skins off the tomatoes, and I got most of the seeds out by putting it in an old colander from the Italian pasta cooking set that I stupidly ended its life early by putting salt in the water. Never salt in stainless steel, people. He had agreed that the meat he would have before going off to work, which is the only time he really wants meat, would be a steak haché. And this is a pure beef Charolais steak haché. And I decided to make a meat sauce. Now I have these beautiful spring onions, and I'm leaving them whole. And I'm saving these tops because I'm sure I'll be able to pick through them and salvage a bit of the greens and sort of use them like scallions. These are some of a yellow pepper ready to go. And since there's going to be meat in the sauce, spaghetti is not appropriate, but he's expecting spaghetti tonight. And I only have that much mixed pasta. Little macaroni types, bow ties, and little shells, which are much better suited for a meat sauce. I will put in a little bit of spaghetti. So there are going to be three shapes in this. Now, this has some little bits of tomato in it. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm bringing it to a heavy boil. I never add oil or salt. Please don't do that. It shouldn't be necessary. What is going to happen is that I'm going to put the pasta, probably all of it, in here. And when I can locate my lid, which I don't see where it is, oh, it's over here. Once the pasta is in, you want to keep it boiling as much as you can. That's what keeps it from sticking. And you want to watch the time for cooking. And if this pasta had different cooking times, I would add it in the correct order. You cover with the lid partially and turn the heat down a bit so it doesn't boil over. And you want to keep it cooking really hard. And as soon as it's ready, and even a little bit non-ready, you lift out the colander. I'm going to put it in the sink. I can pour the rest of the water over it. That'll cook it a bit further. I will put the lid over the colander. And then, a bit before serving, I'm going to twice cook the pasta, which I learned in Italy, and I think it's the best way. I will heat some oil and a little butter in a big skillet and put the pasta in there. And if it's cooled down, I don't care. That'll be fine. It will reheat. Additional garlic can be added and stuff. That's a good way to cook pasta. The sauce is going to be made in the cocotte because it has some salt in it. And first I will put in some olive oil and the meat, which I will break up right away because it's going to be thawed. And you want to break it up right away, otherwise it'll never break up. These onions, because they're so pretty, I just wanted to leave them whole. And then these peppers. And then these tomatoes. And since these are pretty well cooked already, I'm only going to cook them for, like, with the mixture for maybe 5 minutes. It should be a nice dinner. I don't even know if I'm going to make a cucumber salad or anything else with this. You know, we have the French thing, you know, bread, cheese platter, fruit, yogurt, you know. It'll be fine, probably just like this. Okay, sorry I'm doing these in parts, but you know my rule, no editing and no links. And I hope you like this and try it. And my pasta cooking method, which I learned in Italy many times over many years and many visits, is, I think, the best. I mean, they're quite experts, and I've gotten to know the different types of wheat used in it, whether you want hard or refined or whatever. All right.